So now what I want to show you is my new favorite concertina bag, which is the Concertina Compress from Gin. And at the moment they've made two sizes, the 3 meter and the 2.7 meter, I think. And they're really aimed at lightweight gliders. So here we just got a simple system for the zips. As you can see, I can actually leave the glider attached or not to the harness. I'll show you my technique that I've worked out to do that a little bit later. And it's got a little bit of an unusual design for a concertina bag. Here we have the, when you open the glider out, this is the leading edge part here, and here's the trailing edge. It looks pretty standard, but it's just the way that it's kind of like got only a half zip on it to really make it more minimalist. And it's got, as you can see, the buckles rather than the zip. I personally prefer this, but I know some pilots prefer a zip. Perhaps Gin will make a full fat version with a zip. I don't know. So we just open the glider out like so. I leave the glider in a mushroom and I just sort it out a little bit. Like so. Next, so the next bit I do is find out which end is which, and it's easy to tell with a Gin concertina compress bag and the loop here. And put this at the leading edge. And you butt it up against the glider. Like so. You might have to follow me around a little. Okay, next. This is the bit to come and see closely. Because of the way the concertina compress bag folds, you need to do a certain way of putting the gliders together. You need all your shapers, the shapers, in this case nylon rods, to be flat. So the way that you do this, you look closely with the camera, much closer. So what you do is you put the fold flat and you interleave the cells like so. You can actually cheat if you're in a hurry and do two cells at a time, but it's better if you do one. So one. Okay, so now I'll do all the way. I'm just trying to make it realistic. Okay, so now just tidy those up a bit. Okay, as I said, not perfect. We're not trying to be perfect. Next, what I do is get this strap and do that up. Now just tidy up a little bit. So that holds everything nicely in place for me. Okay, next I go to the trailing edge. What I do is just gather the cells as I go up and try and get them a bit more straight. And here, the trick with this is just to be patient and squeeze out the air of it. Good. And back to here. Now, as I do the second side, what I tend to do is I start doing these buckles up. In the packing, you're trying to get a balance between taking care of the glider but not taking forever. A bit rich coming from me. Okay. So there we have it. So you can see how that works. Now this is the bit that's quite different to a normal concertina bag. Now because I'm leaving the glider attached to the harness, I'm leaving a bit of line here, and the reason is I'm going to do this. And now just gently squeeze out the air. I'm squeezing it out, not forcing the air out. The glider too quick. That's great. And now hold it back. And here, because you've got that extra bit of line, you just tuck them in. So you can see here now that this is designed for a lightweight glider, because it's quite thin. It's not deep. So you can squeeze the glider in here and then zip up, just being careful not to catch the glider, which I find, even though it doesn't have a protection there, I find it very easy. Just pull outwards on the zip as you do it. Et voila! Now I just hope that Jin will make a slightly bigger bag for standard gliders and slightly larger gliders, because at the moment you can't really fit. If you have a normal size glider, especially in a larger size, you'll struggle to get it in there. The thing I really like about the Jin Concertina Compress Bag is that when you put it in the rucksack, because it's got a really nice solid shape, it actually stiffens up the back of the rucksack and makes the rucksack better to carry as well. So it's really good.